Hello and welcome to the third video in the Baselight Workflow Series. Today we're going to follow on from the custom format tutorial and we're going to learn how to create a custom burn-in. So this is particularly useful if you need to send out an approval to a client. Say you've finished a grade and now you have to send out a reference file. You want to include the appropriate burn-ins on the image. The first thing we can look at is if we look down in the cursor view, and if we go ahead and if we add a burn-in category, you can see that Baselight ships with two default burn-ins. And if we toggle them on here, so you've got a film light logo, some time code, tape name, and file path. That's the data dailies, and then we have also the film dailies, which is a slightly different configuration. These might not be formatted the way that you want them. Let's go ahead and create a custom format with the metadata that we want. With this burn-in still showing, I'm going to go ahead and go up to the formats tab. Burn-ins are available on a per format basis. So if I wanted to render out burn-ins on a 1280 by 720 clip, I'd need to go ahead and create my burn-ins on this format. But in this case, the file that I'm gonna render out to my client will be a 1920 by 1080 QuickTime. So I wanna be making my burn-ins on this format. So if we click on the burn-ins tab here, you can see that we have two default burn-ins that ship with Baselight. Inside these burn-ins, we have a list of items. And on the right-hand side here, you can see this is where you customize their appearance. Now, you can see that at the moment, everything's grayed out. We can't edit anything. We can't do anything. So this is because the scene format toggle hasn't been selected. So we're currently looking at the factory format, which we cannot edit. So if we go ahead and hit the scene format, now we're editing the scene format and everything comes to life. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new burn-in here. And we're just going to call this client reference. So now we have a clean slate to start building items. There's three options here. You can either add text, which is any of the metadata-based expressions. Text will be things like timecode, file path, tape name, anything like that will be a text-based item. We have a flag, which will display the clip category of the shot. And also we can add an image like FilmLight has done with their logo. So in order to see any of these changes live while we create these items, I want to go ahead to my cursor view and change my burn-in, because we're currently looking at 1920 by 1080, change my burn-in to this new client reference burn-in that we just created. When we have this burn-in showing in the cursor view, we'll be able to see a live update of this burn-in. So let's go ahead and we'll add a text field. So as you can see, text has just popped up on our image in the text field here, and we have it in an item in this list. So if we go ahead and delete this, and if we go ahead and hover over this expression tab, so this gives you all the common expressions that you can use to start creating your burn-ins. So for example, the first one which I want to add is timeline timecode. So if I go ahead and click that, you can see that in the text field, it's populated with this percent timeline timecode expression. If I hit enter, note that you can add as many expressions and text fields as you like within a singular item. But for now, I'm just gonna leave it like this. I'm gonna go ahead and finesse these X and Y settings. So I've changed my X, Y, and scaling settings. And I'm gonna go ahead and add another text item. And this time I'm going to include the path to my image. So if I go here and you can see down here, there's a path to image field, percent image path. I'm gonna go ahead and push enter. And I'm gonna go ahead and finesse the scaling. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a couple more. The next one I'm gonna add is shot timecode, which is over here. And I'm gonna go ahead and adjust my scaling. Fantastic. And I think that's all of the text-based elements I'm going to add. You can see in the previous logos that FilmLight included their own logo. So I might go ahead and include mine as well. Add an image, and I'm gonna navigate to my logo. And I'm gonna go ahead and hit OK. And there's my face. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go finesse this as well. Okay, and now that you can see, my mascot is down the bottom there with my source time code, my record time code, and my file path. Remember as well that this burn-in will only be available in this format. So if I go ahead and change this to 1280 by 720, if I go to my burn-ins, you can see that there are none available in this format. So burn-ins are format specific. If we go to the render panel with Control R and we go ahead and we add all of these render parameters, you can see that in the burn-in tab for this format, we we can access it from here. And we just need to make sure that this client reference burn-in is set during the render with this format to make sure that we see these burn-ins here. And that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial. If you got some value out of it, feel free to head along to my Patreon account and flip me a few coins. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.